Good morning, my dear friends. Today I want to discuss very important topic, the limit. Actually, this topic is very important if you want to understand calculus. If you have no full command over limit, then you cannot grasp the calculus. So basically, limit is the prerequisite for whole study of calculus. And you know very well, in calculus we discuss differentiation and integration and applications of these topics. So all these topics basically generated from the very important topic, the limit. So starting calculus, you must focus on the abstract of the limit, not only algorithm and not only how to solve the questions regarding limit. No, this is not the way. If you want to understand calculus, then give full attention to understand the abstract meaning of the limit. So I'm here to give some light, to throw some light on this topic, because if you are good enough to understand the limit, then you will see that you will have no confusion on the differentiation and integration. Basically, I have seen many students in A levels and in intermediate and in undergrad and in university. Even I have seen many students who have obtained master degree, but they don't have full grasp. They do how to solve the questions by differentiation and integration, but basically they don't know what does that mean and what is the logic behind these differentiations and integration, and what is the application of differentiation and integration in real life. That's why I am here to throw some light on the topic, the limit. Actually, you must understand, why do we find the limit and what is the role of the limit? Basically, a limit means whenever you take any function and you want to see the behavior of the function. If you want to understand the behavior of the function, then you use basically limit. Limit actually you use to see the behavior of the function by nearby value of any domain. Before giving some more light on limit, I will also say you have already seen, I think you have seen in all my previous video, whenever I try to solve any question regarding calculus, I always emphasize on domain. So remember, if you want to solve any question regarding differentiation and integration, all these things based on domain. So whenever you see any question, first of all you must see what is the domain. So domain basically tells you about the input, where you are allowed to move, where you are restricted. You have to be confined yourself in that particular value of the domain. Okay, so here I am. Let's say this is x-axis and this is y-axis, and somewhere there is x, and let's say there is x is equal to a, and this is the curve of the function. And you know, at this value of the domain, here I have chosen, let's say my domain is real number, and in this domain one real number is x is equal to a, and I want to see the behavior of this function nearby
the value of domain, that is x is equal to a. Let's say when you take x is equal to a, you are here and there is value f a. So nearby region is this or this, okay? So this is the region. So if I want to use the limit, actually nearby region of this value, let's say this is nearby region, and this, the difference of this value from this point to this is represented by delta, and in same way this is delta. So there is, you know, x minus delta, and here your x plus delta. As I have already explained, your function basically depends on the domain. So when you take x is equal to a, you have this value, okay? And once again, when you take, when you say the limit, limit means actually the exact boundary value, exact boundary value for any considered input. Limit means any exact considered boundary value, right? When you move from there, or you move from there, either you move from left hand side or you move from right hand side, you approach to exactly that value, that value where your input is taking. When you move from there, from this value of x toward this value where x is equal to a, this value, and by when you reach there, and by reaching there, you get exact value of function there, and that value is called limit. And same way, either if you come from right side, step by step, you will reach there. When you will reach there, you will have again this value of function at a, and that is called, that is equal to L, and L is the limit, right? So I mean, when your function, when you reach there, your value is f a. But when you are there, or you are somewhere there, right? And there is the difference of value. This means you are approaching toward x is equal to a. And approaching me, you have very small difference of this value to this value. And this is delta, okay? When you know there is small difference of the value of x, then there is value L, and then there would also be some output for this domain, and that is here there will be some, let's say there would be some any other value, let's say I say L1, and then say if I go toward the other side, then again you will have, let's say I'm small, I'm representing this, and when you are there, there is small, this is L2. So by changing the domain's value from there to there, you have this difference. If you are changing or moving your x value, then definitely corresponding, if you have corresponding difference of from this value to this value in the domain, then definitely you will have also some difference from this L values to this value which you have taken from there. And the corresponding difference which you have delta for x, there will also be a difference in value for y, for function value. That would be the difference from standard value of limit, boundary value of the function which you have considered, and this difference. And this difference is called epsilon. So when we generally define limit, this means if there exist when you say x approaches to A. I mean x approaches to A. Then the difference between this is called this way. So whenever you have x minus delta, you are taking x minus A, then this difference must be equal, must be less than this value. Whenever you are approaching toward A from x minus A, then there will be small difference in the value of x, and small difference that would be this value. If there exists this delta, delta means there is the difference between considered value where limit exists and there is another point in this range of delta, then there definitely exists this. If this value of delta exists, then there must be also the difference in value of fx minus value of A, okay? And this difference would be, there must be, then if this delta exists, then there will also be definitely, there will exist some difference in the value of fxa and fa and fx, and that would be epsilon. It epsilon could be any small value which represents the difference of two values of x from the standard value where you have taken x is equal to, where x approaches to it, and any value in the range of delta, that is x. And this difference, there must be some difference, and this difference is generally represented by this. So you will this is, if this exists, then ultimately this means there is also, this is basically the formal limit of any function. Now I am going to explain something relevant to this. For let's say if you have like this, and x is equal to, this is A, and you are moving to this, and then there is another, you are moving, either you move from there or you are moving from there. Either this point gives you any answer or not, but if you are moving from this side or you are moving from this side, both, by both ways, your answer must have this answer or must approach to this answer. Sometimes itself it's not included, but you will see that it will be going toward this. So this will be the limit. Then you can say that your left hand side limit and right hand side limit exist. Left hand side limit and right hand side limit exist only when, if either you move from left side or you move from right side, in both terms you reach at the same value of the function. When that happens, then you say or you conclude that limit exists. In other example, I give you another example like this. Like this. And when I say like, there is one function, this, and there. Okay. When I take x is equal to A there, when you are moving from this, you have this value, let's say this one. And when you move for this function from this way to this, you get this value. When you move to x is equal to A from left side or from right side, in both cases you will see that the value of the function different. One value when you come from this side, give you answer 1. When you move from the other side, it gives you answer 2. So when the answer of your function varies by changing the direction, by changing the direction of the domain, then limit does not exist. So you will say that limit does not exist. Sometimes this also happens that you have, when you come from there, this is L. But when you come from there, but you reach there, but for this function, this becomes undefined. But in this case, you can also say that limit exists, because either this is approaching to this or not. But this function gives you this value or not. But you will see that when you move from this direction, but it comes at the same point. So we can generalize, either you move from left side or from right side, trend of the function by the same domain should be the same value, right? So this is the way to generalize. So if you see somewhere that I can give you one more example. Let's say when you have this way and there is x is equal to 0. When you approach toward x is equal to 0, you are coming from this x 0 plus and x is equal to 0 minus. In this case, no doubt you are approaching toward this, but you don't have the exact value because you don't know where they will go. So in these two cases, in this case, limit does not exist, because as I have explained, that either you come from left hand side or you come from right hand side, both sides must approach toward the same exact number. Either they touch it or they don't touch it, but their destiny should be clearly same. If their destiny is clearly same, then you can say that the limit exists. If they don't approach to the same number, that is called limit, then limit does not exist. That's it. And in my next video, inshallah, hopefully I will do some more examples, and I will emphasize more on numerical examples which are generally we discuss, and hopefully those examples will be helpful for the better understanding of calculus. Thanks.